Welcome to the National Healthcare Safety Network, or NHSN, Hot Topic Session. This presentation is a review of a new device-associated denominator sampling protocol for 2015. Beginning in January 2015, hospitals can begin to use an alternative method for collecting denominator data for CLABSI and CAUTI for eligible intensive care unit or ICU and ward location types. This new alternative method reduces staff time that is spent on the manual collection of CLABSI and CAUTI denominator data. The new method requires the collection on the number of patient days and central line and/or urinary catheter days one day every week, for example, every Tuesday. While device day data can be sampled in this manner, hospitals using this method are still required to collect and report the total number of patient days for every day of the month. Upon entry of the monthly data into NHSN for the eligible location types, an estimate of central line days or urinary catheter days is automatically calculated and used as CLABSI and CAUTI denominator data for the month. The next slide shows an example of the data entry screen. This is an example of the data entry screen for denominators for intensive care unit other locations, not NICU or SCA. A new data entry section has been added to the right of the screen that allows for the entry of sampled denominator data. If your hospital has been using the sampling protocol for this location and month, you must first check the boxes to the far right for each device day count that was sampled. Then you must enter the sampled patient days and device days. Once these fields are completed, the NHSN application calculates the total central line days and/or urinary catheter days for the month. Remember, the total patient days as collected on every day of the month are still required. To ensure the accuracy of the estimated denominator data, only non-oncology ICU and ward location types with 75 or more device days per month are eligible to use the alternative method. A review of each location's prior year of CLABSI or CAUTI denominator data in NHSN will help determine which locations are eligible. The traditional method of using every day of a month for CLABSI and CAUTI denominators remains available for all NHSN users. The new alternative method of data collection was tested rigorously in a variety of NHSN locations. We sincerely thank the participating facilities for their efforts to help facilitate this change. More detailed instructions on using the alternative method are included in the 2015 NHSN manual. The rate table output options in NHSN can be used to obtain the total number of device days per location for the prior year. Specifically, you will want to modify the rate tables for CLABSI and CAUTI data. Each rate table should be modified so that the results include one rate per location per year. For example, if you wish to assess the average monthly device day count for the calendar year 2014, you would need to modify the rate tables to include only 2014 data and group by summary year. If you would like to assess a different 12-month time period, such as June 2014 through May 2015, then the group by option must be left blank. Here's an example of annual rates for two locations, produced by modifying the rate table CLAB data for ICU other, with the modifications listed on the previous slide. The average number of monthly central line days can be calculated by dividing the total number of central line days per location by the number of months reported, 12. For 22 ICU, the average number of monthly central line days for 2014 is 71.92. Since this is less than 75, the new denominator sampling protocol cannot be used. For MICU, the average number of monthly central line days for 2014 is 291.25. Since this is well above 75, the denominator sampling method for central line days can be used for this location. CLABSI and COWDI analysis datasets and output options are modified in 2015 so that facility and group users can identify those months in which the new denominator sampling protocol was used. Specifically, variables are added to the line list all summary data, and variables are added to the analysis datasets for the applicable rate tables and standardized infection ratios, or SIRs. While the variables are added to the rate table and SIR analysis datasets, they will not appear in the resulting rate table and SIR output. Therefore, users will need to export the analysis dataset for this detail. In addition, a footnote is added to applicable tables in rates and SIRs when at least 1 month of data was reported using the denominator sampling protocol. Additional resources can be found on the NHSN website and on the Analysis Quick Reference Guide site. This concludes the NHSN Hot Topics update, focusing on device-associated denominator sampling for 2015. For questions, please contact NHSN User Support at nhsn@cdc.gov.